Academy, and I am now here in Aloha Beach in South Florida. Thanks here with a beautiful bay. It's almost no waves because it's a bay, and now it's like about 7 a.m. and the fishermen are coming from the sea. It's just so beautiful. I love this place. For me, a very romantic place, a beautiful place to come with children. This is so calm. And this is my face just after waking up with no makeup. but I really feel to share here a video with you about leadership, teaching leadership for your children. And this because maybe it was a long time I was feeling to do this, but you know, this struggle to Goa, we spend 21 hours on the train from Barcola to Goa. And for the ones who know the Indian trains, you know that the sleeping Indian train, you come in a sleeping AC, and you know they have these beds and the metal things to climb on the beds. And we came there, and it happens that we had a neighbor. We had a very, very nice woman just in front of us, very, very funny, good humor people, local people from Goa. And we had on the other side here also a neighbor in our neighborhood. On the train, we had a mother, and I think it was her mother, so the grandmother of a child, and this mother had a child. We didn't saw the father. This mother had a child there. The child is about maybe less than maybe around 2 years, 2.5 years, around the Nithya's age, our youngest daughter. So I observed during this travel, which it was quite long, that overprotected for the whole travel, which was like a whole day and a night. The whole travel, he could not go out of the sitting place. He was always or with the mother or with the grandmother, and they give some little car, you know, the boy toys car for him to play, and there he was. And while these Divya and Nithya, our daughters, were... Divya was literally the whole day, almost the whole day, climbing the beds up and down and saying, "Hey, look, Mama, I'm in the upper bed, I can climb." Say, "Okay." The whole day climbing like monkeys. And the little Nithya, she was climbing not up, but like all the day, like on the first place, you know, and hanging there like a monkey and playing together the whole day, playing, singing and hiding, talking with people, or with the neighborhood on the other compartment, you know, the whole day like this, and completely free and happy. And meanwhile, the other little boy, he almost don't talk. I have to mention this, he almost don't talk. He just say and scream. He screams, he makes sounds, but he almost don't talk. And he could not move from there, you know. What I observe, I took, and during the night I could not sleep very well because we both slept with them and small bed, and I almost could not sleep. And I had a bunch of stuff going on in my head, and about making videos. I saw a whole video about this, so I end up like, okay, I have to do this. Because I observe that little boy, and I'm sure there are many mothers around it, watching this video, or around the world, that they are overprotective. And that boy is learning that way, and many other little babies are learning fear, are learning that the world is dangerous, are learning that they don't have freedom to move, to make their moves and try out the world. And I can imagine that being raised like this with his mother and his grandmother, one day when he grow up, it will be very hard that he try out the world, you know, that he make his own stuff, that he be different from the crowd, you know. He's just, you know, afraid of everything and insecure. So we have to remember ourselves that we are raising the future generation, that we, according with the education that we give to our child now, this will make them in the future. So how, what kind of adult, what kind of person do you want to make in the future? Who would you like your kids to be, you know? And I am not better mother. I never know how to be a mother, you know. I was not raised with kids. I was the youngest child. I have no experience with kids. I did not learn so much. I did not read so much about this. I've been a mother of two since these last 2 years, being myself with the things in what I believe, and Jayan also. However, he had more experience with kids. And the thing I want to share with you, if it's right or not right, but you know, truly I believe that it's what I believe is right. We are raising our kids. We are raising them by being independent. You know, since they first to start, I talk with them and we both talk with them like adults. You know, since they born, we talk with them normally. It's like, ooh, la, la. You know, we talk with them normally. Since they born, we explain things. We say how things are. For now, we came to do it. When we have to go to the embassy, making some documentation. We are going on a long travel, and after we go to plane, go, you know. But we explain things, everything. They know what is going on. And so, the first thing is talk with them normally, you know. Explain them about life, about what is going on. And the other thing is that, and this stuff just came up naturally, that as soon as they start to walk and they become independent, a little bit more independent, I put their clothes and their shoes in a compartment on the room where it's more lower. Sorry. And they can reach that compartment easily. So what happens is that Divya, since a very early age, she's now 4 years and she dresses herself alone, totally. But Divya, since a very, very early age, I remember since just a few months after she started to walk, she started to choose her own clothes. And maybe in the beginning she picked a red with a blue. Maybe sometimes I tell, okay, this is not matching with this, and maybe she choose another one. But from the beginning, she choose whatever she wants. I'm not worried with what the other one's going to think about the clothes she wear. I'm paying more attention about letting her choose her clothes, letting her choose her things, her shoes, her little necklace. You know, I let her choose. I let her feel that she have the power to choose, that she is independent, that she have value to decide her own things since very, very early age. And today, who knows Divya and who come here to Shiva Garden Homestay in Barcala Beach, this beautiful touristic place, who knows Divya, the ones who have the opportunity to know her, know that how, you know, she's really independent. She do her own craft and she opened her own way. She have her own head to think, and she knows very well what is right, what is wrong. She knows how to choose people. With some people she make big connection there, and some other people she just don't connect, you know. And she choose her clothes, she choose her stuff. She knows what she wants, and this is very important. Because a child like this, you know, it's not so easy to just, they know what they want, you know, she opened her own way, she opened her own path, with security, with self, they are self-secure, they are self-confident. And Nitya, she's already also choosing her clothes, she's 2.5 years. After some months she started to walk, she's also started to choose her clothes at the moment. She's not yet dressing alone, but she's definitely choosing her clothes. And sometimes she say, I don't want that, mommy, I don't want that, but okay, what do you want? Maybe for the mothers it's a little bit more work, I don't know, I don't think so. It's just more patience, you know, that you are there and you let them choose, you give them, you teach them leadership, you know, teach them leadership, teach them what do you want, is this or is this, what you choose, you know. And they choose, and they sit in the floor and they have this box with their own necklace and, you know, beauty things, and they choose whatever they want. While this, I am doing my own thing, I'm not looking to them, and I'm doing my own stuff, you know, dressing myself or whatever stuff. And this is one thing. Another thing is these little things, these little details in the day to day make really a difference, you know, make really a difference in shape them character, in independent, brave and courageous people out in the future, you know. This is one detail, letting her choose. They have all their stuff in a lower compartment and they choose their own stuff. Another thing is that still today we sleep all together. We have a bed on the floor, a big one bed, and we have a double bed and a single bed together on the floor. And still today they sleep with us. They sleep with me and Jayan, and they have their own space. And since they're born, they always sleep with me. They were breastfeeded, both of them, and they slept. Every night I put them to sleep. I give them the milk. I put them to sleep. They know that I am there. Any moment in the night, they ask water or they ask if I am there. I don't take too long to reach them because they are not in a separate room. And because the bed is on the floor, morning time, even though if we are not there when they wake up, they know very well we are around. They wake up, they come out from the bed, so we are not afraid they will fall or something, you know. The bed is just on the floor, they come out from the bed and they go to see where we are in the living room or in the garden, and it's no crying, you know, no fears. And this was one of sleeping, having them sleeping with us. It's co-sleeping. You can search on the Google with just co-sleeping and all the advantages of this. Even though I was not raised like this in Portugal, and no one do this in Portugal or in Europe or in USA. Everyone met kids in a different room, and the babies cry for I don't know how many minutes until the mother reached them. My heart, you know, I feel this is not right, and that's why from the beginning they sleep with me and I'm just there reachable. They hear my voice at the first moment they call me, I am there, mommy is here. This builds up on them this makes a big difference in their inner peace, in their security, in their self-confidence, you know. And you can be sure, this is my own experience, and who knows people who came here, our friends and also our guests who come to Shiva Garden and knows our daughters, they can say, you know, they are free little babies, you know, they are independent, they are self-confident, they are not fearful, you know, they are not raised in fear. From early babies, from a very early stage, you know, they don't have to wait for the mother to come 10 minutes until you know, they never ever had to cry a whole night because I'm not breastfeeding them. When I stop breastfeeding, I start to give milk, but until today, I never denied milk to them. Night time, and I also work, you know, I'm not a housewife, I work, I wake up morning. I remember when Nitya born and Divya was about 2 years, you know, I don't know how, I think it was God giving me all that energy because I was waking up five times a night, and then I get up very early to do my practice about 5 a.m. or something, and then during the day at 7 a.m. they wake up, and then 9 or 10 or 11 I go to work, you know, and I had no naps during the day, and then I go all over the whole day until 9 p.m. where I sleep. I think God gives us energy to do this, and here I'm jumping from one subject, which is the co-sleeping, to the other subject, which is be there for your baby, you know, breastfeed or give milk to your baby. Don't leave your baby crying the whole night for 2 or 3 or 5 nights until they stop asking you at night time. I never did this to them. I have no heart to do this. For me, it's okay, you know, they ask milk, I am there for them. It's my duty as a mother. I choose to bring them, you know. I have no right to deny. Anyway, they stop asking you at night time in some point of their lives, you know. Now, Divya is not asked. Divya is 4 years. Since long time, she's not asking milk night time anymore, you know. And Nitya, honestly, she's 2.5 years. She's not asking. Drink milk night time anymore, and now they sleep the whole night, and I sleep the whole night, but I never had to pass them through a huge trauma like letting them 4 nights crying, 4 nights in a row crying because I decide and my husband decided it's time to stop the milk night time, it's time to blah blah blah, you know. We never did this. I never let them crying 4 or 5 nights in a row until they stop crying, asking me my time, ever, ever. And believe me, we both work like you, like any person in Europe and USA, we both work. My husband rests a little bit more, but I didn't have naps, I worked the whole day. And I'm here, you know, I didn't die, I was maybe a little bit more tired, but sometimes I was asking, my God, I don't know how I have this much energy, and I think God gives us energy, you know, the goddess gives us the energy to hold on, and, you know, and I believe that when we don't make them pass through a huge trauma, early babies, like letting them cry many nights in a row, this also builds that their character, you know, because it's a huge trauma. It makes lots of hormones and stuff going in their brain all the time that they are screaming and crying. It's huge, you know. Don't do this to your kids, you know. Be there for them. It was your decision to bring them to the world, to make this baby born. So take that responsibility in all ways, you know. And this is my opinion. I never pass my babies through this trauma, you know. And after some time, maybe 2 years, maybe 1.5 years, I would say maybe 1.5 years, 2 years, they stop crying night time and they don't ask me anymore. they still wake up sometimes to drink water, and I give water, and then I sleep again. What to do? You know, it's my job, you know, it's my duty as a mother. But I believe this brings a lot of peace to them. And okay, in the way to raise them, we just raise them, teaching them. They have their own heads to think. They can make their decisions. We give them freedom to make their own decisions. Building up self-confidence in them by being there for them. Jayan teach them a lot, adventure and climbing and all these things. And we just make the little touch when they do something wrong, they should not do. They are correcting them. When they pass the mark, sometimes we make a scream on them, maybe a little, how it says, in the bump, a little bit in the bump, but we make corrections when they need, but we do teach them. They are free, they are independent, you know, they can think by their own head, they have to think by their own head, and they have to see people, the good ones, the not so good ones, the ones, you know, to choose to read the energy of people, and be self-confident, you know. And what happens, the result of this is that they go out to the garden, they go out. In this travel, it was 21 hours, and then we had to go to the embassy yesterday, and we spent the whole day there. They behave, you know, they don't cause us any problems. They behave well. They know very well they have to be patient in the embassy. They just took the phone, they see some cartoons, or they took naps. You know, they just, it's like they know they have to be patient, and they have to wait, or the train. And they just switch off, or they just play in the train, they just play. And it's okay, we let them play, you know, because we know they are strong. We know they really hold well on the metals, on the beds, and we let them free, you know, because this is very important. This is very important. And what we can say is that they behaved really well. They gave us no headaches, you know, no crying, nothing. They know we are there for them if they need. And, you know, we had the travel. We are tired from the travel, but we are not tired for controlling them or looking after them at all. Whenever they want, they come to us, they ask food, they ask to sleep, they ask cuddle, but they don't give any problem at all. And this is a little, it's just about this, I feel, to pass to you, to inspire you, that inspire your, you know, that raise your kids freedom, in self-confidence, you know, validate your kids, make them feel validated, that they can do their own decisions from early age, the most smallest decisions. It starts like that, you know, it does not start at 10 or 15 or 18 years, it starts from baby. Validate them, teach them leadership, teach them they can do their own decisions, teach their adventure, you know, and build them up by making whatever the corrections that they need to have. But validate your kids, you know, teach leadership to your kids, and you see how they grow. It's just amazing to see. I don't believe in raising children in fear, in not validating them because they have 2 years or whatever. I don't believe in this, you know. They are the kid, these children that are born in our days, they are old souls and small bodies, you know. Don't castrate them. They will be the future. In some point, they will be the future of this planet. Don't castrate them. Don't, you know, don't raise them in fear. Validate them. Praise them. Hug them. Kiss them. Love them. You know, give little gifts to them. But the most important, love them. Be there for them. You know, teach them leadership. Teach them they are special. They are unique. They are. Tell them they are, how independent they are, how proud you are from them, you know, how beautiful and smiley they are, how happy child they are, how intelligent they are, you know. Praise them, love your kids, praise them, and hug them and love them. Make them the new generation that it's coming up to look after this planet, you know, and this environment. Build up the new generation with awareness, with mindfulness, you know, with intelligence, with love. Thank you very much. See you next time.